Well, if you've ever wondered what's under the ground you walk on, now you know. In South Georgia, it's limestone, soft rock formed from ancient sea animals. And if you're in North Georgia, the rock that forms Stone Mountain is also what's beneath your feet, granite. But I'm not going to say solid granite. Here's why.
Let's go on down this way. Watch your step. What we're going to see here is part of Cloudland Canyon, but this also shows us how Northwest Georgia is formed.
Millions of years before the dinosaurs, the top of Cloudland Canyon was at the bottom of the sea. It seems unbelievable. Alan Padgett, who works for the Georgia Department of Natural Resources, he can explain.
So how is this created? I mean, it seems impossible for something.
The way all this got here was a very long, long time ago, probably 400 million years ago. There was a great ocean here. And then there was a tremendous mountain building episode that took place and shattered these rocks up very high and made these big mountains very much like the Rockies. But because they were shattered, the frost and the water and the rain and everything eroded them away and left us with a valley like this where a mountain used to be. And so the water that falls in the forest through these leaves and stuff is slightly acidic, and it goes into these little cracks in the rock and makes caves. And so these mountains are actually hollow underneath. I mean, the earth is not solid. The earth has voids in it. And what we're going to do is go down and go into this mountain and see it from the inside. Lots of folks look at mountains from the outside, but we're going to see it from the inside.
Deep.
Yeah. We've got to go up to go down.
There are about 350 caves in Northwest Georgia, which makes these mountains full of holes. Think of them as enormous hunks of Swiss cheese. Cave exploring is serious business. Alan is an experienced caver, and he makes sure everyone is wearing the right gear, including a helmet equipped with a battery-powered light.
Coming into the darkness, let's get our lights on. Okay, we ready?
Yes, sit down.
Yes! Sit down, and that's the way to do it. It's nice and easy, just sit. See? Okay.
It's a long, slippery descent into the darkness of the cave.
Watch out for the slipperies. Okay, we get to crawl right through here. Come on up. Get it? Sit down on your rear end here.
Groping for a firm rock to grab onto, searching for a safe place to put their feet. Finally, the group emerges into a large pitch-black room carved out of the rock by an icy cold stream.
Well, let's go on up the creek.
Walking in the underground creek takes some getting used to, but with every step, the cave reveals another of its wonders. Just overhead, small bats cling to the ceiling, peacefully napping in the chilly darkness. It seems miraculous that any animals could live here, hanging from the barren rocks.
Now on these rocks, y'all be careful, because they're slippery and we're slippery.
It's awesome. This huge cavern created by layers of rock that shattered and crashed to the cave floor in some violent upheaval of the earth. It looks as if it all could have happened yesterday. But this pile of rocks has been here, undisturbed, for no one knows how long, perhaps millions of years. And there are other, even more fantastic natural phenomena in this cave.
What are these things called?
These are formations. If they hang from the ceiling, they're called stalactites. They hold on tight. And sometimes there are ones from the floor coming up that are called stalagmites. I don't see any right around here, but there are some. But these are rock.
They look like icicles, but they're actually made out of rock. And the water, as it comes through, leaves a little crystal right around the end of it, like this one right here. You can see just a drip right on the end of it. And then as the crystal grows and grows, it gets bigger into these. And one of the things we don't want to do is we don't want to touch these or bother them, because these are growing crystals. And if we put the oil from our skin or the mud from our glove, it upsets the crystal growth in these formations and it destroys it forever. It'd be like walking in a forest and touching a tree and killing it, but then no tree could ever grow back there again. They're that fragile.
Where's the water come from?
Well, this creek we're standing in here comes from drips just like this coming out of the rock, and it just grows and grows and grows, and there are little minute cracks in the earth. And the water that rains upon the earth goes into these cracks under the soil and comes through the cave, and then comes very quickly through the cave.
So it comes through the cracks and then drips down these and then makes the
And then makes creek. The creek and then comes out in a spring in the valley.
Oh. Oh, wow. Look at the formations up here. These are stalagmites and stalactites. And then when they join together, it's a column.
How long does it take them to form?
These are formed at the rate of about 1 cubic inch per 100 years. That's probably, you know, a million years worth right there.
The cavers journey back towards the sunlight, once again squeezing through the tight spots and slipping and sliding through the icy mud. The adventure's over. The kids have traveled through time.
Ah, daylight.
They walked on the bottom of an ancient ocean. They wiggled through caves that were made millions of years ago. That's why Alan Padgett respects this part of Georgia. And he asks the kids to do the same.
One of the things we need to remember when we go caving is, I guess best said by the caver's motto, is we take nothing but pictures, leave nothing but footprints, and kill nothing but time. And get a little muddy at the end.
You've got mud on your face.
Just a little.
Just a little.